we're back for a quick deck tech with, is it Murktide this time, as opposed to Jeskai? As a friendly reminder, if you do like red-based content, especially decks like Murktide and Burn, please consider subscribing to the channel. And as always, let's get into the deck tech. So, this deck's a little bit different than the Jeskai version we've been playing that was Aspiring Spikes version. This version, number one, doesn't play any white cards. Number two, gets to play Fury. So we have a little bit more interaction against creature decks, a little bit more consistent mana base, a little bit less damage to our mana. The downside is you don't get to play things like Prismatic Ending and stuff, so if certain things resolve, like Rest in Peace or the like, you're going to have a hard time removing it. That said, still the same powerful shell. You're playing Ragavan, you're playing Darcy, you're playing Murktide, you're playing Counterspell, you're playing Archmage's Charm, playing Cantrips, you're playing Unholy Heat and Lightning Bolt. Very powerful deck overall. Managing graveyard is quite important, as the tension between Darcy and Murktide region can be quite real. However, you are playing a lot of cards like Mishra's Bauble, Consider, Serum Visions that fills up the graveyard quite quickly. Expressive Iteration after turn two tends to be two mana draw two of your top three. And then the rest of the deck's just kind of cheap pressure interaction, trying to get there before your opponent can overwhelm you with card advantage or go under you, etc. Deck is basically the closest thing to a tempo deck in the modern format, outside of maybe Grixis Lurrus, that has like Ragavan, Darcy, and different things like Kroxa and such. It just depends on the build. But this might be the lowest to the ground deck in the format that is a tempo deck other than that. Beyond that, sideboard, a little bit different options, as we're not multicolored or the third color. So you're playing Engineer Explosives to answer hard-to-reach things like, Death Shadow, etc., which can be a problem to kill other than Unholy Heat in your deck. Death Shadow, Engineered Explosives, etc. Jace to give you a little bit of power against the grindy decks. Mystical Dispute and Flusterstorm against fellow blue decks, whether they be Cascade, whether they be the four-color Urion piles, etc. Relic of Progenitus, just generically powerful. Anti-graveyard card, dressed down, pretty good against the Urza Saga decks. And one of the big draws to playing this variation is the ability to play Blood Moon. We'll see how often that comes up, winning us games out of nowhere that, could give us problems otherwise. But that's pretty much the deck. Like I said, a little bit different. Some of your sideboard cards are a little bit more high impact, but you do lose some of the high impact white cards, no Prismatic Ending, no Dovin's Veto, etc. So we are a little bit more vulnerable to certain things, a little bit less vulnerable to others. We'll see how this version does after taking the Jeskai out for a spin for a couple weeks. So that said, let's get into the matches. All right, we're here for match number one with, is it Murktide as opposed to Jeskai? Opponent is on a companion of some type. It is fine. Kahira. Ugh. Kahira can be a rough matchup, not gonna lie there. Up against Thank you. All right. So, Belcher. Strike it rich. All right. So, Blood Moons, Veils, Furies. Luster Storm, I think, is a fine card. Our Furies are actually kind of useless. Chase is an interesting card, though, I think a little bit slow. So I think we just bring in Mystical Disputes, possibly. Go down Unholy Heats, potentially. I bring in the Jaces or the Engineer Explosives? Relics are kind of whatever. Blood Moons aren't good. Furies. I guess Furies are at least a threat. Albeit a really slow one. Just bring dress down. I have no idea. Hands a bit awkward. Opponent's effectively drawing a land. We're doing that because we want to try to draw our one of Force of Negation. That is not a Force of Negation. Use our worst counter spell here. Sure. I'm gonna presume we're just dead here, but you know. At least get to see our opponent's deck. Nothing terribly. Sand seems fun. Opponent kept 7, which is moderately terrifying. All right, pass turn. Sure. Do you have another one? Kind of hard to beat the ridiculous god hands, just saying. All right, well, that was fun. That was a weird match. Like I said, kind of hard to beat the God Hand. Alright. Back for match number two after one hell of a game against, whatchamacallit? We're up against the Luris deck. Interesting decision here. Yeah, that's generally a card you want against the Luris deck, I suppose. Yeah, I'll keep this in case they are a Thoughtseize deck. Alright. Swamp, probably not good for the home team. Presume we take Ragavan here, right? Yeah. So are we up against the Darcy pile ourselves? Okay. Sure. Is an interesting card, but I think we put it in the graveyard. Let's gotta suspect something's up here. That's a card to leave on top. Okay. Looks like our opponent had a shadow that they wanted to get in going here. card type am I missing anyway? Sorcery. If they end their unholy heat, this is dead, so it's kind of whatever. You have a terminate? That's annoying. Pretty sure we're dead here. All right, unfortunate, but I played well. All right, well, Blood Moon could potentially screw with them a little bit. Engineered Explosives could potentially mess with them a little bit. Flusterstorm could be okay in some spots. Relic of Progenitus could be okay in some spots. Like what cards are actually draw this, I guess. And keep with Basic Island. This hand's interesting, but kind of bad at the same time. I did waste an unholy heat there, but I don't think it would have mattered. was dumb. I should have just. Unholy heated that puppy, but you know. Interesting. Okay, do I leave something on top? Oh, that's annoying. Should have countered that, huh? I hate dress down. should have just countered that. Then we would have been home free, pretty much. So many mistakes. All right, we are back. I punted this match so hard, so bad. All right, well, we go from rough beats to rough beats, it looks like. I think we might be forced into running six here. Is it Teferi? Feels like a Teferi. Alright, well, not quite sure what's going on over there, but these all seem like possibly perfectly reasonable cards, as does this. Fury seems a little out of place here. Bolts, who knows? Jace's, who knows? These are the cards I would consider. Like this, I guess. Hand seems fine, I guess. Cool with just letting one of these guys die, I guess. Sure. That's an interesting one. Sure. Opponent is tapping low, which is nice. Their prismatic ending, yeah, that's a thing. Wasn't quite what I had in mind there. It was supposed to be Dash Monkey, but you know. Can't seem to not make mistakes in this league. Let me guess, Teferi Bounce. Alright, well, here goes nothing. Sure. Alright, here we go. Fun, interesting game of Magic. Alright, well, despite punting massively, we're able to kind of steal a win here against four color control. So, what a weird league.